this thing. So this weekend, I had the fever start to go down a little bit, and I started to feel it come into my chest. So I went to get a chest x-ray, and I want you guys to see this just so you can see what we're looking for and not, okay? Now, Doc, obviously you understand this. What we're looking for in the lungs are big white areas. What are the terms that people will hear? What are they looking for, and what do you see in this mighty expanse of chest in front of you?
Well, I mean, you're right. I mean, one of the things that you'll hear is infiltrate. Do you have an infiltrate in your chest, in your lungs? And that's basically a collection of inflammatory fluid. I would look for those in areas where, you know, the black areas are the air in your lungs. I would look for some of those black areas to essentially be filled with white spots. And I just want to make it clear for the audience, I'm not diagnosing here from afar or via television. Chris and I talked about this earlier today, and he obviously had his own doctor look at it as well. In the middle of the chest x-ray there, you can see you have a little bit of infiltrates, and you can see this on, this is the side view now. You'll see in the sort of middle of the film there is your spine. You see those sort of domino looking bones, awfully small, I might add, Chris, for a big guy like you, in the middle of the spine there. And then in front of that is the x-ray of your lungs. And it looks pretty good. Maybe a little bit of fluid buildup there, but not something that I would definitively call pneumonia, which is what they're trying to diagnose. Pneumonia is not just diagnosed by a chest x-ray, but it's one of the tools that doctors use to diagnose it. So it looks good. And again, make it clear, I'm not diagnosing Chris via television here, but that, you know, looks pretty good. And I looked at that more closely on my computer today.
Right. Look, and I had different pulmonary people look at it. They take very gross readings, because it's either really pneumonia or it really isn't. And they expect me to have infiltrate because I have the virus. And I have to tell you, it is scary to have your lungs go up there and see this stuff and be like, what is that? What is like that smoke in there? And they tell you, yeah, it's the virus. It's in there, it's in you. You have to fight to keep it out. And, you know, I'm doing fine. I don't have pneumonia, but if I wanna stay that way, you know, I got to have some things fall in my favor.
Yeah, I think you make a good point, Chris. I mean, obviously, you know, you're getting doctors who tell you, look, you should take it easy. I obviously was counseling you last week, even, you know, why don't you take some time off? And I think you make a good point that you need to keep your lung, you know, you're doing some these pulmonary exercises, these breathing exercises, which your doctors have advised you to do. And that
no
can be critically important as well.
No high heart rate,
no real
strenuous
exercise,
anything. No. But just getting my lungs and doing the breathing is more than I can handle right now. But I believe in it. I believe in it as a discipline that if you want this out of your lungs, you're going to have to keep it out of your lungs. And if you just lay on your ass, you're going to get it. I believe that. The cases I've been hearing, the longer people lay down, Sanjay, the more trouble they have.
Yeah, I mean it's a balance, I know, for people, because this wipes people out. I know it wiped you out for a bit. You were taking these naps, 3-hour naps during the day, which is something I've never heard you do, but you were tired, and it just wipes people out. So again, I don't want to minimize that part of it, but you're right. You know, as much as you can keep your lungs moving, you know, do these breathing exercises. There's these machines that allow people to actually breathe in and out. It helps, you know, and you know, we're all learning together here, but there are some truisms when it comes to preventing lung infections, or at least diminishing them, and that's one of them. And you know, your chest x-ray, you do have a little bit of those white spots in there. Luckily it's not a big infiltrate anywhere, so no real signs of pneumonia, but you can see, as your doctors tell you, what the virus has possibly done to your lungs there.
Yeah,